Hello everyone, welcome to OTM TV, and I am your host Bensika Ibinabo, and this remains Let's Talk. Shortly, I'll have with me in studio someone who is aspiring for a vital position. Don't go anywhere, stay tuned and find out more details about them. We'll be right back.
Nope. Get inspired with beautiful native verbs and inciting programs only on Wakrikeset Radio. It's informative, educating, entertaining, and costs less data charges. And that's less than your WhatsApp consumes. To tune in, visit radio.wakrikeset.org and just press play. Only on Wakrikeset Radio.
Welcome back. With me today in the studios is someone you would want to meet with the whole of your heart, and you want to know more and know why he's here today. So quickly, I'll introduce my guest to you. Good day, sir. You're welcome to the studio of OTM TV.
Thank you very much.
All right, my viewers would like to meet you, sir.
All right, my name's Kasho Stamnosike Abi. I'm from Ogu in Ogubolu local government area. I am vying for the position of the chairmanship of the council. I'm from Ward 2, Unit 7, in Ogubolu local government.
All right, so under what platform, in terms of the political party, are you coming?
Okay, I'm contesting under the platform of the People's Democratic Party, PDP.
Oh, that's beautiful. Mm. Having read your manifesto, sir, you said you're the man fit for the post of chairmanship. So I'm wondering, or my viewers also will be wondering, what makes you so sure, and what do we expect from you, and how can you revive the LGA?
All right, thank you very much. You agree with me that Ogubolu local government area was created on the 1st of October, 1996. And going by that assertion, Ogubolu local government will be 25 years old by 1st October, 2021. And as a local government, we are supposed to be celebrating our silver jubilee. Now, I want to ask this question. What have we achieved as a local government? What are the prime projects? What are the milestones we can say we have achieved in this local government in the past 25 years? That is where Kasho Stamnosike Abi is coming in. In the next 25 years, Ogubolu local government is going to be 50 years. I want to set a roadmap. I want to set a blueprint that every successor that will come after me is going to key into. We've always been dependent, so much dependent on federal government allocation. We're so much dependent on federal government allocation that every chairman that comes wants to sit in the office and wait for federal government allocation. I want to change that perspective. That is why, if you see in my manifestos, I said Ogubolu local government administration is going to have a paradigm shift, and Kasho Stamnosike Abi is going to bring about that change.
All right, sir. We are excited. We are expectant to know how you're going to do it differently. What are the things you've set out to do? You said you leave a roadmap. So, yeah. What are the things? What are the signs we should look out for? What are the things we should do? Because it is said, easier said than done. So, yeah. What are the workable plans put in place by you?
Thank you very much.
If given the opportunity.
Thank you very much. If you watch in my manifestos, I said every project that I am going to embark upon is going to be PPP-driven. PPP-driven in the sense that the public-private partnership, the government will have a role to play, the state government will have a role to play, the private business people will have a role to play. Now, I have set out this roadmap so that by the time I get into office, we will make series of consultations with the stakeholders, the community leaders, the chiefs, the youths, the women leaders, and all the stakeholders in the community. We are going to get their priority project. But before then, I'm going to invite the professionals in the local government so that we sit down in a round table and fashion out how we are going to develop this local government. You know, we don't want this normal trend of people waiting for local government, federal government allocation before we can embark on projects. Fine. The federal government allocation is there. It will come. We will pay salaries. We will do the little we can. But my target is to see that we establish an institution that is going to take care of the youths, the unemployed, and at the same time to generate revenue for the local government council.
That's beautiful. Going by your manifesto, you talked about the PPP as regards the economy, and I believe you said that, but could you enlighten the people what PPP is and how you intend to merge it in your administration? Just a line or two.
All right, thank you very much. PPP is simple, an abbreviation of public-private partnership. Public-private partnership. The government is a stakeholder in this. The individual entrepreneurs are stakeholder in this. The local government is also going to be a stakeholder in it. It's very simple, very, very simple. We identify a project we want to do. We bring a percentage of the amount for the project. The private businessman will bring in a percentage of the amount. The state government is going to bring in a percentage of the amount. It's very simple. At the end of the day, you will see that whatever project we have in mind to embark upon, we just go home and sit down and leave it for the contractor to handle.
Oh, that's beautiful. I hope my viewers have understood what he meant by PPP. Moving on to the next on your manifesto is agriculture. Yeah. I love what you said, but I'm looking at who are your target audience. You know, our youth seem to want it very fast.
Yeah.
And agriculture seems to be like a slow return on investment.
Yeah.
Although we know that its return is massive. But our youth want it quick. So how can you channel their minds to agriculture, that they should invest, they should be a part of agriculture, that agriculture is the end team now? How would you do that if given the opportunity?
Well, nothing good comes easy. We don't expect anybody to be fast or to have quick returns in any investment. Agriculture, you know, is the end thing now, because oil is fading out gradually. We thank God we have the oil reserves, but from all indices, oil is going to fade out very soon. Now, we are surrounded by water in our terrain. We are not only looking at maybe fish farming or poultry farming, livestock farming. We are looking at industrial revolution in the maritime industry, as in maritime fishing and all that. We are going to look out for vessels that are going to go into fishing trawlers. You understand? It's not just something that you just empower the youth, give them nets, give them canoe, they go to the shores and fish. No, we are looking out for something big. All these are going to come in place when the man that has the wherewithal. Because it's not something that you just say you want to give the youth money to go and do fishing. No, we are looking out for investors. We are going to look out for investors that will come. You see our terrain. Our terrain is very good for such kind of fishing, industrial fishing, where we look out for trawlers, fishing trawlers and all the rest.
Even with the polluted state of the water?
Well, the water is polluted, but it's just within the shores. If you go outside the shores at the high sea, the waters there are not polluted.
Oh, beautiful. Thank you so much, sir. But rumor has it that the political system in this local government has to do with nepotism and godfatherism. Even the governor confirmed it on Saturday when he said that it will no longer be that way. Everybody should vie for the position. But, you know, in Nigeria, it's one thing for the authority to say, it's another thing for the people involved to do. Do you think it would be possible, if you're given this opportunity, that you would do everything you've said wholeheartedly without anybody saying, my court's deal? Because, you know, Bolo local government, it has been perceived that the leadership is one imposed on, because everybody has a court. So do you think you can actually materialize this vision of yours?
Well, thank you very much. I don't intend to fight the leadership, because if a party, the party is supreme. Whatever the party says counts. But like I said, It all depends on who is there. I am an individual. I have my principle. I know that somehow, we are going to have some areas we are going to disagree. But by and large, what is the paramount thing? What is our paramount interest is to see that the local government develop. So we must disagree to agree. So in terms of that, if I am being given the opportunity to serve, what is there? Whatever is due to anybody will be given to the person. But be rest assured that the local government council, the local government area is my paramount interest. And I'm going to do everything possible. As long as I have outlined my programs, I'll make the leadership to understand that this is my program. And if there are any reason that you are going to deviate from this program, I will call the leadership to order. This is what we want. And we're not going to go against it.
And what if they go against it? Or peradventure, the percentage after, distributing each person's percentage, and the percentage left for the local government is something that is not workable. How would you do that?
See, this project, this PPP project I've just outlined here, public-private partnership, the local government has a stake, the state government has a stake, and the private individuals that have a stake. I am going to look at the resources that is coming to the local government. And I am going to say this. State government, the allocation is coming from you. Because when the federal government releases the allocation, it gets to the state first. State government, pay the worker salary. Pay the overhead. Give us the security vote. Whatever that is left, let it go into the PPP project.
All right. Lastly, 2002 to 2004, our local government was booming. Like, we had workers in and out. There was no time that local government was quiet as a graveyard. But that is not the case today. How would you change that, the working culture of the Ogbomosho local government area? Make the council busy, whether the chairman is in or out, there should be somebody.
See, I keep saying this thing. If you know what you are carrying, you will never miscarriage. It's just that the previous administrations that have come into this local government, just like you said, 2002 to 2004, the administrator there was a very vibrant person. And after then, all the chairmen that have come, they've all seen this local government as just to come and sit and wait for allocation. We have to be up and doing. We have to be up and doing. Look, I have a lot of plans that I've earmarked. If by the special grace of God, I succeed in getting this chairmanship position. And between me and you and the God I serve, I am going to do everything possible to make sure I make this local government an envy of the state.
We look forward to that.
Thank you very much.
All right, thank you so much for coming to our studios. It was nice having you. And we hope you win. Like he said, you know what you carry, you cannot miscarry. So we have heard what he carries, and we hope he does not miscarry. Till we come your way next time, I remain Bensika Ibinevo.
I just want to cut you a little bit. I want to say something for the final word.
Okay.
I have watched from inception of this local government, even before the local government. I think in 1993 or thereabout, Senator George Sekubo was the chairman of Okreka Tai Eleme local government. Senator George Sekubo wasn't a chief when he was the local government chairman. Senator George Sekubo wasn't a chief when he was the SA on the governor on project. Senator George Sekubo wasn't a chief when he was the first timer in the House of Rep. I think Senator George Sekubo became a chief when he was in the Senate. And the Senate, the chief they gave him that time was an honorary chieftaincy title. Later, before he became the chief of Etemwa Kenu House. The same thing to our governor. Our governor, when he was the chairman of the Obiapo local government area, he wasn't the chief. I think it was when he was the minister of education that he was given the chieftaincy title. I want to state this clearly. This local government, it should be left for a vibrant person, people with a broad mind that is ready to take the local government to the next level. Any man that said he's a chief, Let him go and take care of his work in the house. And let a young, vibrant man do the job of a council chairman. Thank you very much.
All right, thank you. Seems Mr. B is doing end chief involvement. That's his own protest. So bring the youth up. I think his protest is about bringing the youth up and whatever. And brutality, and old people involved in our administration, give the youth a chance.
Yes, yes.
So thank you very much for coming to our studios. It was nice having you in our studio.
Thank you very much.
We look forward to having you another time as regards the educational discussion.
Thank you very much.
But for now, this is all we can take on OTM TV. And this is Lester. Till I come your way next time, I am Bensika Ibinabu. And this was put together by Michael Spacoliti and Don Dave. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.